watching that. The only thing that is quite big enough, but there's a kid down here. It's too bad to be bad. But then, hunting it up to 70 miles an hour, below the fastness of the land level, where hearts are very, very critical, and you have to get plenty of air into the lungs. So weight is critical, and if a girl comes with overweight, when she has cubs, she might get a heart attack, so might the cubs. There, it's a different set of criteria. We really don't want them to go overweight, but we first got them marketed and ballooned up to 64 kilos. That's much too much. We cut them down from 7.5 kilos between the blue and baby to 5.5. We've probably upped it a little bit now, but they're all now roughly the same weight, 50 to 54 kilos, which is a bad price. But we do feed them well when they're stone frost and ice on the ground, the biometric pressure's down and then the lactic. What I'd like to end up doing is just talking to you a little bit about the great athleticism of cheetahs. They are the supreme athletes of both the cat world and the animal world. As I said, they can run up to 70 miles an hour, and they do all their hunting by bursts of sprints. And like that supreme Olympic athlete, Usain Bolt, who 2 years ago was over here successfully to defend his Olympic titles in the 100 and 200 metres events. Within their back legs, the better to enable them to sprint, they have fast twitch fibres. Not only that, their collarbones and neck bones are disconnected, so when they make their final pounce for the prey, they can the better capture it. And indeed also, when they make the final pounce, all four legs are off the ground, they can swivel, they can oscillate, they can rotate in any direction they want. They're incredibly lively, awesome and mobile, and if any of you have ever seen the film footage of cheetahs running in the wild, while the backbones are almost void and disconnected. They are mighty, mighty athletes, and a final, very useful bit of information. They are the only big cats that have non-retractable claws. Well, that's not technically strictly accurate, they're semi-retractable. But they will take the lions and tigers, and their claws in sheaths, have been sheaths. You take where the white tiger is, the lions I looked after all their life. Look there to Carter and Warner. He died second of the two on the 9th of March last year. We were very close because he had missed him through 5 hernias and stepped in for 9 months. And we were very close to the end. It was, well, sounds it sounds because he had a long, happy and varied life. He was thundering out his daily greetings to me 2 days before he died, and he was only ill for 1 day. But as I say, we were very close. Any day I wanted, I could put my hands into the cage, pull back the sheath to his paws, and show people just how big they were. These guys throw out the whole time. So we have to keep the most strong to go home and well shopping. Thank you very, very much indeed for listening. I do hope it was interesting. Thank you for your cooperation. Do enjoy the rest of your day.